the mayor being carried out on a stretcher.
The husband of the Windermere town manager got into a heated argument with the town mayor. The mayor collapsed, but it's not yet clear if he was pushed or if he fell.
There are a lot of questions that need to be answered about what happened today. We have team coverage.
WESH 2's Greg Fox joins us live from the Windermere Police Department. Greg, you just spoke to the chief of police.
I did just talk to the chief of police. We'll have his comments in just a second, but most importantly, the medical update on Mayor Bruin, and that is that he is home. He had been taken to Health Central last night for treatment after he apparently hit his head or hit his head on the floor. We're not entirely sure, but apparently he's okay and he is home and he is recovering at this hour. Let's show you some tape from what happened last night inside Town Hall. Conflicting reports here about who may have pushed or punched whom, but you can see the result. Mayor Bruin was on the floor for several minutes and may for a time have been knocked unconscious. His head hit a table and he went to the hospital. Some witnesses claim the husband of town manager Cecilia Bernier pushed or punched the mayor. We'll get to more on that in a moment. But Chief Mike McCoy tells me he's turning over all witness statements to the state attorney's office to see if any charges will be filed on one or both men. Frankly, he was shocked by what happened.
Windermere doesn't deserve all this, I don't think. I mean, holy cow. You would expect this in some communities, maybe, but I think that's what makes it so newsworthy is it's Windermere. I mean, I grew up in the area, not in Windermere. I was on the east side, but Windermere kind of has a pretty classy reputation.
And that was new chief Mike McCoy. Of course, continuing our team coverage on this story, here's more on what happened to lead up to apparently a confrontation that sent the mayor to the hospital last night from WESH 2 News' Michelle Meredith.
All was quiet at the mayor's Windermere home this morning. According to a friend, Gary Bruin appears to be out of the hospital and recovering from the unexpected events of Tuesday night.
That's all I'm saying is that he's in pain and he's resting. Thank you.
The Windermere Town Council meeting seemed destined to be contentious. It started when the mayor took a verbal swing at town manager Cecilia Bernier, made a motion to fire her, said she never should have hired Dan Saylor as police chief, that she knew Saylor was corrupt, and so, the mayor indicated, is she.
There's no reason that the town manager should avoid a ticket. Is the town manager qualified to avoid a ticket, or should she be allowed to avoid a ticket?
Next, it was the town manager's husband's turn at bat. Roland Bernier trashed the mayor, made a host of personal allegations, then had a seat.
I got the lady's name. This
you are totally out of order, sir.
At some point, the mayor approached the town manager's husband, and exactly what happened next is up for debate. Some say the mayor got in the town manager's husband's face.
He touched my husband.
Others say it was the town manager's husband who got aggressive, shoved the mayor into a table.
You're good.
When it was over, the mayor was flat on his back on the floor, left the meeting in an ambulance, while Roland Bernier, the town manager's husband, proclaimed his innocence.
You pushed the mayor. Touched me first.
You pushed the mayor.
Come on.
No, I did.
And that was WESH 2's Michelle Meredith reporting. We will continue to follow this developing story in the town of Windermere, not only in the angle that deals with the confrontation that happened last night that led to that trip to the hospital for the mayor, but also what started all of this, and that was the arrest in January of former Chief Daniel Saylor, who yesterday had additional charges filed. He's now facing 6 felony counts in relation to the alleged cover-up of a child rape investigation that ultimately led to the arrest of his good friend Scott Bush of Windermere. We'll have more on this beginning on WESH 2 News First at 4, and as always on WESH.com. Live in Orange County, Greg Fox, WESH 2 News.
Greg.